announcements for this Sunday. We are still congratulating those who have or will be turning a year older this month. Happy birthday to all of you. The United Methodist Women meet via Zoom and phone call every second Saturday. Please contact Mary King or Helen Ricks for more details. Bible study is Tuesday at 7 p.m. via Zoom and phone call as well. Everyone is welcome, and you can contact Pastor Kathy for more information. Everyone is also welcome to the food bank on the fourth Thursday of every month in the church parking lot. If you would like to help or get food, contact Pastor Samuel Cruz. Virtual youth group is on second, third, and fourth Sunday. Contact Trisha for more information on that. Echoes of Praise meet second Monday at 6:45 p.m. Also, if you would like to join the Sisters of Praise or get more information on it, please contact Melanie Pleasant for practice dates, times, and more information. Thank you for tuning in to this announcement. See you next week, Saints, and keep on praying. When I think about what is done for me, I get excited when I think about what is done for me. Hey, that's what he's done. That's what he's done. Ooh, what he's done. That's what he's done. I won't forget. That's what he's done. I can't forget. That's what he's done. He picked me up. That's what he's done. He turned me around. That's what he's done. He paid my fee on solid ground. That's what he's done. He's been my rock. He's been my shield. He's been my will. In the middle of a wheel. And I got to give him praise. I got to give him glory. I got to testify. I got to wave my hand. You ought to shout for joy. You ought to stomp your feet. You ought to lift him higher. I, yeah. I don't know what you come to do.
I don't know what you come to do.
I don't know what you come to do.
Welcome. Welcome to Trinity Sunday on this Sunday of Memorial Weekend. We come just thanking God for the witness of the space that you've carved out, and we are grateful. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on us and on the space that we've carved out to worship you in spirit and in truth. Let us praise God with all that we are. Amen, amen, and amen.
Call to worship. God is here. The triune God is present with us.
God is revealed as the great I am, the miracle worker, and the power to keep.
God is here. The triune God is present to us.
God is revealed as the awesome, the absolute, and the always present.
God is here. The triune God is present for us.
God is revealed as the God who was, the God who is, and the God who will always be.
God is here. The triune God is present.
We have gathered to worship and adore the God of yesterday, today, and forevermore. God is here.
God, those prayer requests and those concerns, Father God, some that we have spoken out loud, some that we have thought about, some that are on our heart, Father God, and some, Father God, that will come. And Lord, we just ask, Father, that you look upon them, Lord, because you already know what they are. You just asked us to seek and we shall find and knock and the door will be answered. And Father God, we know that when we talk to you and we pray to you, that you already knew it was coming, but you wanted to hear from us, Father God. You wanted us to fellowship with you, Father God, to be one with you, Father God. And we know that there are many gathered here under the sound of my voice, Lord, that are praying, Father God, as one to you, Father God. And you have heard the prayer requests and the praise reports and the needs and the, Father God, the requests for healing and Father God, for comfort and for joy, Father God. We just ask that you look upon us, Father God, and that you continue, Father God, to have us lift our eyes to you, lift our hands to you, Father God, and lift our prayers to you, Father God. Lord, we just thank you for all the blessings you have bestowed upon us, Father God. And as we come, Father God, we just ask, Lord, that you remember us, Lord. For it's me, it's me, Lord, standing in the need of prayers. Yes. We come praying for our mothers and our fathers and everyone else, oh Lord. But it's me, oh Lord, standing in the need of prayer. And Father God, my prayer may not have been spoken out loud, or it may have been spoken by someone else, Lord, but you know the individual need, Father God. We're asking, Lord, that you place your hands upon the top of our heads, Father God, and bless us from the very top all the way down to the tippy toes of our feet, Father God. And Lord, that you help us, Father God, to continue to use our feet to walk on that path of righteousness for your name's sake. We know we're not perfect and we're going to fall short, Father God. We ask that you use our hands to catch us, Father God, that we may be able to dust them off, put them together, and call upon you, Father God, that you may continue to walk with us, pick us up, dust us off, and send us back where you have sent us in your beginning, Father God. And Lord, we just ask, Father God, that you continue to provide for us, Father God, spiritually, physically, mentally, Father God, and just continuously, Father God. We just ask that you continue to give your angels charge of our lives, that they may go before us and make the crooked road straight. Lord, we know that people are out there driving all crazy, and people are out there up to their shenanigans again, Father God, taking the lives of others, Father God, fighting and looting, and they're just doing things that weren't being done specifically during the time of rest, Father God, that you placed upon the world. And Lord, we just ask, Father God, that you be with those, Father God, who are in desperate and dire need, Father God, that you allow them to see that there is another way, Lord, that they can lift their eyes to you, from which cometh their help, knowing, Father God, that someone spoke to them, or someone has introduced them, someone has planted a seed, Father God, someone is there to take their hand and invite them to church to meet you, Father God, or to reconcile with you, Father God. Lord, we just ask, Father God, that you continue to use each and every one of us to go forth, Father God, and be that witness that you have placed upon this earth, Lord, that the light within us will shine so bright that men will see it and give you all praise, all glory, all honor, Father God, because you are so worthy. And Lord, if you never bless us again, you have already done enough. Father God, we just want to bask in your presence and just bask in the things that you have placed within our reach, within our sight, within our hearing, Father God. And Lord, we ask that you make us sensitive to the Holy Spirit, Lord, that we can hear from you and do what you have called us to do. These and many other blessings we ask in your precious and holy Son, Jesus' name. Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. John, the third chapter, the 1st through the 17th verse. I'm reading from the New International Version. Now, there was a Pharisee, a man named Nicodemus, who was a member of the Jewish ruling council. He came to Jesus at night and said, "Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher who has come from God, for no one could perform the signs you are doing if God were not with him." Jesus replied, "Very truly, I tell you, no one can see the kingdom of God unless they are born again." "How can someone be born when they are old?" Nicodemus asked. "Surely they cannot enter a second time into their mother's womb to be born." Jesus answered, "Very truly, I tell you, no one can enter the kingdom of God unless they are born of the water and the Spirit. Flesh gives birth to flesh, but the Spirit gives birth to spirit. You should not be surprised at my saying, 'You must be born again.' The wind blows wherever it pleases. You hear its sound, but you cannot tell where it comes from or where it is going. So it is with everyone born of the Spirit." "How can this be?" Nicodemus asked. "You are Israel's teacher," said Jesus, "and do you not understand these things? Very truly I tell you, we speak of what we know, and we testify to what we have seen, but you still do not accept our testimony. I have spoken to you of earthly things, and you do not believe. How then will you believe if I speak of heavenly things? No one has ever gone into heaven except the one who came from heaven, the Son of Man. Just as Moses lifted up the snake in the wilderness, so the Son of Man must be lifted up, that everyone who believes may have eternal life in him. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. For God did not give his Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him." The word of God for the people of God.
Oh,
Pastor Kathy, the pastor of St. John's United Methodist Church. And I want to thank you for tuning in with us today or all the other days that you've tuned in with us, and that we've provided this YouTube video, but my sermon is actually taped live on Sunday. So I invite you to check back for the sermon, as this week's sermon is The Chosen Birth, Trinity Sunday. And in this sermon, it's my hope to talk about the witness of a chosen birth that each of us have had experience through a maternal birth through our mother. But that was a birth that we did not choose. But today, our scripture helps us reflect on an opportunity for us to have a chosen birth. You know, you hear mothers talking about a chosen child, or families talking about a chosen child through adoption, or adopted child indicating that they were chosen out of so many that were there in the orphanage or on the list for adoption. But this Sunday, I'm going to talk about what it means to have a chosen birth. And so please do catch the upload of the sermon from Trinity Sunday, The Chosen Birth, anytime after 1:30 on Sunday, May 30th, 2021. God bless, and you are chosen. Amen.
Think of your next chapter, your best chapter. Hallelujah.
How can it be that you love those unlovable men?
I heard that program.
Ha ha! Yeah!
To be free in some place to live, and you, I'm waiting.
young people going to stand up real quick. Come on. Come on, we gotta stand. Yo, everybody, come get your bounce on, get your bounce on, get your bounce on. Don't be cute with it, you gotta get, come on. Fifth ward, fourth ward. Come on, sing it.
When I close my eyes and think of you and reminisce on all the things you do, I can't imagine my life without you. It's like paradise now, I know that it's real.
This is the time in the service where each of us can participate. It's time for offering. Each of us should give what we've decided in our hearts to give. Giving comes from the heart. God wants us to be joyful and compassionate when we give. See 2 Corinthians verse 9. When you tithe, you are putting God first. That's Deuteronomy 14 and 23. Tithing is an act of worship. God doesn't need your money, but your place of worship benefits from your giving by maintaining the ministries it offers. We have the food bank, the gardener, the clothes closet. We need cleaning supplies, water for our neighbors. I'll bet you didn't know that the less fortunate use our water to wash themselves, to drink, and whatever else they use it for. That's our job, to help the homeless and the people that can't help themselves. We are to be the hands and feet of God. We use electricity to send our worship service over the computer and telephone and the airways. So tithes and offering is a very important part of who we are as Christians. I invite you to give your first fruits with a happy, loving heart. Times are hard, but trust God. In Malachi 3:10, God says, "Test me, and I will open up the windows of heaven for you and pour out all the blessings you need." Give your place of worship a tenth of what you earn. I believe if you do your best, God will still bless you. You can't beat God giving no matter how hard you try. So participate in worship by giving your tithes. You can mail them to the church or drop them off on Sunday. And for more information, call the church at 323-564-5638. Thank you, family.
Jesus.
Jesus, my life will never be the same.
I found
someone who truly.
Come on!